Welcome to this presentation series on addiction e-learning for physician wellness. This project was created by the Association of Faculties of Medicine of Canada, AFMC, with funding from the Canadian Physician Health Institute. The Canadian Physician Health Institute is dedicated to improving the health of Canadian physicians and is the result of cooperative participation between the Canadian Medical Association and the Canadian Medical Foundation. Each presentation in this series is available online as a podcast and can be accessed at afmc.ca. Throughout this series, you'll be hearing from leading professionals specializing in addiction and mental health. Today's presentation is provided in partnership with the Northern Ontario School of Medicine and delivered by Dr. Michael Kaufmann at a live session for Northern Ontario learners with simultaneous broadcast through OTN and ePresence.
It's my privilege to introduce Dr. Kaufmann to you for this hour talk. Dr. Kaufmann graduated with a degree in medicine from the University of Toronto in 1979. He completed his training in family medicine at the University of Toronto, then received certification from the College of Family Physicians of Canada in 1981. The College of Family Physicians honored him in 1991 with a fellowship award. After 14 years of practicing family medicine and addiction medicine in rural Ontario, in 1995, Dr. Kaufmann became the founding director of the Physicians and Professional Health Program, or PHP, of the Ontario Medical Association, a service designed to assist doctors and other health professionals with substance abuse, psychiatric disorders, and other personal health problems. He received certification in addiction medicine from the American Society of Addiction Medicine, ASAM, in 1996, and the Canadian Society of Addiction Medicine, CSAM, in 2000, and is presently a diplomat of the American Board of Addiction Medicine. Dr. Kaufmann is the outgoing chairman of the Canadian Physician Health Institute Advisory Committee and the past chairperson of the Physician Health Committee of the Canadian Society of Addiction Medicine and the Canadian Physician Health Network, a national affiliation of the physician support programs. He is also a faculty member of the Physician Manager Institute of the Canadian Medical Association. Dr. Kaufmann is an invited speaker, a teacher, and a consultant nationally and internationally, and has written extensively on the subject of doctors' health. In 2003, Dr. Kaufmann was awarded the Queen's Golden Jubilee Medal in recognition of his work in the field of doctors' health. In 2007, he received the Courage to Come Back Award from the Center of Addiction and Mental Health. And in 2009, he was awarded a Lifetime Achievement in Addiction Medicine Award from the Addiction Medicine Section of the Ontario Medical Association. Dr. Kaufmann and his wife, Judy, live in a rural setting where they enjoy walking with their pets, gardening, and skiing. Most of all, Dr. Kaufmann is an avid golfer, lover of the blues, and everything acoustic guitar. He does his best to live a healthy lifestyle and to practice what he preaches. It's my honor to introduce to you Dr. Kaufmann.
Thank you very much for that kind introduction. And quite seriously, that last bit is really, really accurate. So if we have any other guitar nuts in the room, come and find me later. We'll okay, I see one right there. We'll chat. Anyway, listen, it's my great pleasure. It's my great pleasure to be here today, to see you all here today as well, and to know that there's an audience distributed out in cyberspace and beyond as well. So I thank you very much for the invitation to join you. Thanks to NOSM for giving us this opportunity to be together and to make the recording of this message. Thanks also to Hillary, who has invited me here on behalf of the Addiction Medicine Interest Group for the second time. So Hillary, where are you, Hillary? Hi there. Thanks so much. And also, of course, to the AFMC, the Association of Faculties of Medicine of Canada, for collaborating and giving us the opportunity again to distribute this message much more broadly than here today in this room and at this moment. I really very much appreciate that opportunity. So indeed, we're going to talk about us today, which is not a subject in medical training or even in medical practice that we talk about together that often. So again, I very much welcome this opportunity. And broadly speaking, we're going to look at our health in a very general way to begin with. We're going to look at substance use disorders in our profession in a little bit more detail, looking at risk and how these kinds of problems present and how we help one another when these problems are present, and a little bit more about treatment, follow-up, and sort of long-term outcomes. Very importantly, though, and I hope by the end of this session that you can appreciate, one of the most important takeaway messages will be, well, if you are concerned about a colleague or a friend in the profession, just exactly what do you do about that? And of course, I couldn't leave without just reminding you about the Physician Health Program, which I am the director of, the medical director. And so you understand that we're there for you and now and onwards throughout your career. Now, my usual approach to having this kind of presentation is to do this as a conversation, and I would like to be able to ask you questions. I would like you to be able to ask me questions wherever you are. But for the sake of making this recording and to use the time to our best advantage, I think today the best thing to do will be for me to go through the material with you, and I do have a fair bit, and then open it up for questions at the end. So it won't stop me, though, from asking you some questions or asking you to reflect at the very least, and if that prompts you to write down some ideas or to offer some feedback towards the end, that would be great. So here I have a slide here. It's kind of a cartoon. I actually begin most presentations with this, and if you've ever heard me speak before, then you've seen this slide before. I like it. Men are from Mars. Women are from Venus. Different. Doctors are from Krypton, really different. And this is my way of sort of not only poking fun at us, but just exposing the whole idea that as we go through our professional training and onwards into practice, there can be a tendency to forget, as we become more and more professional, to forget who we are as regular people. And the message that I have today is, you know, putting the metaphoric white coat on may confer a sense of specialness, and you are special. I don't mean to say anything other than that, but it's the reminder that inside the white coat, sometimes we feel more like this, stressed, anxious, and think that we might be the only one who feels that way when really we all feel that way from time to time. So this is the reminder. I always want to start my presentations with the message that first and foremost, we're regular people and we have all the same needs that regular people have. And really, in that way, we're much more like our patients than we're unlike our patients. Well, this may seem like a bit of a no-brainer, a self-evident kind of question which says, why does our health matter? And for the most part, I'd say it is a bit of a self-evident kind of question, but there are a few special considerations when we think about our health. It's not just that we matter as people and we matter as professionals and we have to be well to be there. We have to be well to be in the game. We have to be well to stay in the game. We have to be well to continue to enjoy our work. We have to be well to do our best work. We also have to be well in order to bring our best self to our work. I have been privileged to respond to many thousands now of, if you caught some of the dates in that introduction, you'll realize I've been at this for quite a while. Many thousands of referrals to our service, and many of those doctors I've spoken to personally, and a significant number are indeed referred to us because of, let's say, they're not behaving as well as people around them would like. And when we're not well, it's not hard to behave well. So that's just yet another reason to look after ourselves. But there is some research that's interesting around this that I do want to share with you, done by Dr. Erica Frank. Now, she first of all, she did some other research, which I'll show you in a minute, about our health from an epidemiological point of view. But she has told us that doctors who have good personal health habits are much more likely to advise their patients about healthy lifestyle and good personal health habits. But that's not all. Doctors who make those sorts of recommendations and who live healthy lives themselves are instantly seen as being credible to their patients. So this is a message that means something to a patient. And as those of you who are in practice already know, and those of you who are on the threshold of that, you'll be finding out very soon that the counseling that we offer to our patients actually makes a difference. Our patients trust us and they listen to us. So if we practice what we preach, then the message is that much more credible and that more readily offered. What does that all mean at the end of the day? If we look after ourselves well, our patients will be healthier. And at the end of the day, isn't that why we're all doing this together? So there's a lot of reason why we ought to be in our best possible health. The good news about us as a population, again, Dr. Frank has told us this, is that we actually do have pretty good health. And when we're surveyed, we report that we have good health. We do tend to have lifespans just a little bit longer than average, and we do report good health practices. All of that said, we also do report that we are not always satisfied with our work-life balance, and that we don't always find our workplaces the absolute healthiest. And of course, as we're about to learn more today, we do have a certain risk for, I'd say, occupational risks that lead us towards substance use disorders, psychiatric disorders, and other kinds of related problems like that. If we didn't, I don't imagine that I would have this job that I do now. And by the way, I started that years ago all by myself. And today there's 20 or so people in my office. And together we're all working very hard to respond to the needs of the many callers that we now have. And there has been some research, not Canadian, but there has been some research that does indeed indicate that our suicide rates are higher than they ought to be, let's put it that way, and perhaps a little higher than matched populations. So it's like I said. We get calls every day. The first year I was doing this job, I got 10 calls. I was thrilled. I took off to see every one of those docs right in their home or their office, wherever. 100 the next year, 200 the year after that, almost 1,000 last year. You can see the trend. Add it all up, and as I said, it's thousands of callers, and they're calling us using words and telling us stories as depicted in this slide here. What I want to do is explore a little bit sort of the underpinnings of the various kinds of stresses and strains that we have in our profession, somewhat generally, but then I want to focus in a bit more on the substance use disorders specifically. It's useful to have just a rudimentary understanding, that's all that's required, of this particular graph here, which is quite simple. It's called the human function curve, and basically it shows that our performance gets better the more challenged we are. Stress here is just an arousal challenge. It's not meaning to use the word in a negative way. But as the amount of stress goes up and our corresponding performance improves because we're being challenged and stimulated, there's a diminishing return after a point. That's the hump there. And going over the hump is when the stress is simply too much for our inherent ability to deal with it. Over that hump is the fatigue. Over that hump is the exhaustion and ill health. And I'm here to tell you that almost all the callers who reach out to us, certainly those who are more seriously troubled, are all living life on the right side of this curve, rather than on that lovely place just to the left of the hump where we're cranking on all cylinders and performing and happy and satisfied. That's where we want to be, but medicine pushes us over that hump, right? Here's another way of depicting it, just in a simple graphic, a simple cartoon, of carrying the load. And the problem, you see, is when we don't get a chance to put the load down. So I have a question there on the bottom. How do you know when the load is getting too heavy And I just asked you to reflect. Wherever you are, whatever you're doing, pause for a second and think of a time when that thing you just wanted to put that down and it was difficult to do. What was it like for you? Mental.